Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Before I start this, there's a little thing that I forgot to add on the right side there, a courage gem. Thank you for telling me about that. Alright, let's go in. Sure looks like I was in there. Well, okay, yeah, I wasn't there before, but I mean, it looks like that I've been in there since the end of the last part. Link, I knew you'd be visiting soon.
So you know Grandpa? How do you know him?
You see, for generations our ancestors lived to serve the Ocean King. They defended the Ocean King in an age when great evil lurked in the sea. My people forged our own weapons and fought in epic battles. You seek one of those great weapons, an artifact called the Phantom Sword.
So we need that sword to defeat Bellum, like Grandpa told us.
That's right. Bellum has the power to drink the life force from you. Only the Phantom Sword can slay him.
Got one around here somewhere?
Now you must find the Phantom Sword and defeat him, Link.
Okay, let's get Bellum, Link. So, Zauz, will you let us borrow that Phantom Sword?
I no longer have it.
What? Like, why would he get rid of something so important, really? Like, if the sword is so powerful, why would he...
Yeah, you get what I'm saying here. No, I do not.
You've got to be kidding. Why tell us how we should defeat Bellum when it's pretty much impossible?
Don't jump to conclusions. I am Zauz, the blacksmith. I may not have one now, but I can make one.
Oh, you can? Okay, then. Well, what are you waiting for? Make one.
I can't. Oh, come on!
You can't?
Ooh.
What do you mean you can't make one for us? Are you joking?
The Phantom Sword is no ordinary sword. When forged, normal metal can never handle that kind of sacred power. Aquanine, Azurine, and Crimsonine. These three pure metals must be forged together to create the Phantom Sword. That also might be Crimsonine, too. I'm just not sure of the pronunciations, but anyway.
Come on, Link, let's go find those three pure materials. So, where can we find those three materials?
Long ago, the Ocean King gifted the pure metals to three tribes in this world. The three tribes must have passed these treasures down over generations. Visit those tribes, and they should be able to tell you the location of the metals.
Three tribes, but where are we supposed to go? We've traveled a lot, but we've never met someone who had a pure metal.
You must go in search of sea charts. You will need more sea charts in addition to the ones you already have. Enter the Temple of the Ocean King and get the next sea charts.
Then we already got to the bottom of the Temple of the Ocean King.
Yeah, that's true.
There weren't any other paths we could have taken.
There was a door that you could open by drawing a symbol, was there not?
Hmm?
If you draw the symbol on that door, another way should open to you.
Wow, who knew that door had such an amazing secret? Make note of the symbol and let's go to the temple, Link.
Good luck out there, Link. So, I'm gonna chat with him one more time here. That's basically the same thing that he just said. So, okay, what I'm gonna do here is mark it on there. Now, this is sort of like a puzzle that you gotta draw in one stroke. It goes something like this. Start at the top, go to... Oh, that was a terrible cornery cutting, but you go to the middle, then you go down and around, like so, and we go up like that, and then we go up to the top. Now, I leave all these little lines broken so I don't get it all confused and mixed up like this one could potentially be. So that's good enough as it is. Alrighty, so Temple of the Ocean King. With the power of warps, we can get there pretty fast, I must say. So you found out how to beat that. What, a sword? Pure metal. Hey now, why is that every time we... Fine, I'll follow you until the end, but only because of how desperate you are. And then you'll beat that bell. Got that, Link? We gotta set sail. All aboard, we're off to the sea! Yeah, sorry for cutting through that dialogue a little bit too quickly there. I tapped too fast for my own good. Anyway. Actually, I probably don't even need to cut ahead. I could just do something like this. And that should take me over to the one in front of Merkay Island. And there we go. Isn't that nice? And then we go to our route, and then we doodle up to there, and then we go to Merkay Island. Alright, I'll just see you there. Pick that seagull. And here we are. So now that we're here, we're gonna see that, well, we got mail. But there's something else that's around this spot here, I think. This is a letter from Linebacker. Here goes. from Lineback to Link. Okay, this is weird. Why am I writing to you when we're together all the time? Just give me a moment to remember why I was writing you. Why didn't he leave this out in his letter? Oh, whatever. Oh, so I'm writing because, well, I'm grateful, all right? Happy now? Thanks, okay. There, I said it. Well, this is awkward. What's next? How about, thanks for working like a dog for me, you treasure dog. See? That's something you just can't say to a guy's face, you know? One more thing. A gift to show my thanks. Keep it to yourself, or else. Hey, I got a ship bar. Don't know why he just didn't attach it to the ship himself, but maybe he likes the way I customize it. And that's the end of it. Yep. Got all that, sir? Then I'm out of here. Okay. So, now up here, as I was saying, there should be someone hanging around. There you are. Yeah, you know this guy. Sorry for being so loud. Thought you were going to walk on by, so I got a little too excited. Anyway, have you heard about the Chief of the Frogs? Yes, I have. Oh, so you know that. Are you sure? Positive? Okay, fine, I'll just... You want me to say no, don't you? You'd likely to encounter many golden frogs swimming in the sea, but one of them reigns supreme, a giant golden frog that rides on the wind. I do believe that he's been spotted around here. Yeah, we already got that. Oh, the sea holds such mysteries that it makes it so alluring. Now, here's a secret that I'll share with you. I've come across a treasure map. Want the treasure map? Then hand over 50 rupees. This is the only way to get this one. So, that's why I wanted to talk to him. So, yep. Get a treasure map. There we go. There it is. Voila. As I say, X marks the spot. Sail there and use your ship's salvage arm. Now I'm going to go by that tree that I'm supposed to dig by and, well, dig. Okay, so which tree was it? Which tree? This one, maybe? This one? Probably. Might be. Oh, hello there. Treasure map. What's up? Woo! Alright, Temple of the Ocean King it is. Now just note that there's something that you can do through there now that you got the bow. You know, shoot an eye and go through the path there, but I'm gonna save that for a little bit later because it's not really super important to do so. So I'm just gonna let this earthquake happen and go into the temple. Another earthquake! I can sense it! It's coming from the temple! So Bella must be causing the earthquake because I keep rattling the island. Hurry! Let's get the sea chart and find the pure metals! Indeed we should. Alright, so we're in. A little audio glitch there. Okay, you're just gonna repeat yourself. That's fine. So, we gotta redo the first six floors, only they're gonna be a bit different this time, so I'm not going to do some cutting, got it? Good. So I'm gonna go down, and uh-oh. New kind of phantom! Oh no! They actually kind of make things easier, in all honesty, these red ones. You'll see why. That one is red! Why is that phantom red? It looks more powerful than the ones we had to face before. That evil monster is a swift phantom, as you might guess, much faster than the other phantoms. Oh, great. Even if they are fast, it doesn't matter as long as they don't see you, right? He's right, so be extra careful and sneaky, Link. So yeah, the reason why I think they're a bit easier is because, well... Yeah, they're faster, so we can actually run around a lot quicker around the areas by following them, because they run, well, I should say walk at a faster speed and run at a quicker speed as well, so yeah, you can kind of do things in a more swift fashion. And that's kind of why I like them over the regular phantoms, for the sake of speed and whatnot. So yeah, you know how to do this. Thus far, so it's not really that much to repeat here. Just like 30 extra seconds to get through this floor, and then we come down here. And now, let's see. Gotta wait. There we go. Go. You know the deal with this. It's gonna go straight down, and we go around. Here we go. Plop this. And you notice that there's a swift phantom down there, but he doesn't really ever come into play. Ever. And there we go, got that key, and he's going around that way. Good, that works in my favor. He's hanging around the center now. Okay, and well, actually maybe he does come into play, because now I have to wait here, because he's gonna try and go up there, and if I were to try to get that key, he'd run after me. So I guess he does kind of get in play if you get a little bit too fast for your own good and he doesn't go back the other way.
Oh, yeah, that's right. They like to pick up items and stuff. Well, what we can do, I guess I could show you, is, oh, shoot. Oh, that didn't attract them, Willy. That's weird. Well, okay. Yeah, just kind of go around here carefully and, seriously? This is just much easier to do when you shoot them in the back. There it goes. It stuns them like those Reaplings. And then you can get the key. Yeah, so I guess it does come into play. I just normally didn't do it that poorly. Alright, so now I got the key. I'm gonna go hop around here. Actually, it doesn't matter if I get seen now, because if I... Yeah, I'm gonna be over here by the time you even get over there, and that other one's gonna be blocked off by the bricks. You know, that the switch blocks off, and yeah, there we go. Alright, number three. Now, there's actually something that we can do here on this floor, now that we got the bow. But first, I'm gonna go and grab the usual routine of 30 seconds. And open this up. Voila! Because I get a force gem, and then I can kind of go at a snail's pace around here, and yeah. you might find it easier to actually drop the Swift Phantom down below in a trench. Well, not a trench, a hole this time, because of their whole, you know, they re-pick up keys and stuff like that as you go, so it's a little bit more tricky here than otherwise. I don't want to get my... Oh! That was poor timing on my part. Oh, I got too close! Okay, so I want to go and... Yeah, I know there's the other one right over there in the corner, but I'm not going to do that one just yet. I want to go and... I can kind of do that to attract them. Oh, wait, I thought that was... Well, I thought that was a... maybe it was too close to the edge. I don't know. But anyway, I got him out of the way, and whoops. I'm going to hop down here, and I guess I will go grab that key. Oof, poor timing again. Okay, what's with the slowdown going on here? That's weird. Ah, whatever. Alright. We got ourselves another triangle. Oh, yes. The shapes will lead the way. And by the way, you should also be trying to go through here as quickly as possible, and I just realized that I forgot to shoot that eye up there while I was up there. Whoops, that's okay. I can always get a better time off camera. Like, by the time we get to the sixth floor this time, there's going to be something different, and we're actually going to be able to get a checkpoint for the Temple of the Ocean King, because we will be kind of have maxed out the floor possibilities here, and thus we won't really need to come back to these floors ever again. And thus, there'll be a checkpoint for us to, do the thing, but, that was bad timing, because that Swift Phantom is going to be in the way. I should probably wait this out for another cycle. So let's just wait this out. It doesn't take too long. And there it goes. Oops. It actually made me put away my item. Dang you. Okay, now that it's there. Yeah, I should have watched the other Phantom a little bit better. That was my own fault. It's alright. We'll be just fine. Yeah, it's a power gem! And that's why I wanted to do that little rigmarole there. And I should also get that 30 on my way back through there as well, of course. But first, I'm going to try and sneak by you. There we go. And now I can do this. You know the deal. And I should actually be able to just, like, rush right over to, yeah, said thingajigger, because he's going to be going the other way by the time I get there, and yeah, I can just run right through there at a, well, as fast as I can run through here. Obviously, the point of this is to, sort of kind of get you in trouble with the Phantoms, but, well, once you get the routine down on these floors, it's not that big of a deal or anything like that. And, there we go. Woo. So, the differences in the floors are probably going to become more prominent to you coming up to the next floor, actually. Not this floor, I mean, not the first three floors here, because, well, you'll see where they make a difference. So, here we are at the midpoint, I guess you could say, of sorts, that without any worries about our Phantom Hourglass running dry. And now, you can go on ahead. So, now over here we got more Swift Phantoms. You know the deal with the boomerang here to get it set up ahead of time. But first, actually,
Yeah, I should do this. That knocked off a whole bunch of the wind things, as you could tell there, so we got ourselves a lot quicker. Oh, shoot. That was a bad move. I wanted to draw a boomerang. Whoopsie. I'm gonna... Yeah, I can't do that while you're on me, can you? No. Poopers. Whoopsie doodle. Okay, that's fine. And what I want to do really, right, coming down here is... I forgot you were there again. I mean, I forgot that you were there entirely. I'm stupid. What I want to do is get that plus 30 in the corner, but I'm just wasting time here. I'm clearly not concentrating. Okay, here we go. Oh, that missed? Are you serious? There we go. Okay. And now I get that. There we go. Now I'm going to go... I guess I can run through this, actually. He's not that dangerous or anything like that. I'm just going to run through here. And yeah, just kind of does its thing. Thusly. And now, get the bombs. And... maybe I should have waited, because now I gotta wait for them to do their loops. Okay, oh, whatever. Bombable wall, I'm gonna go back over here, actually. You son of a... I must have just been in range of it, for it to be, actually detect me. Alright. Okay, let's go. Alright, there we go. And we hit this. I said we hit this, then we go get the key, and then we go to the locked door. There we go. I think I'll be able to, yeah, I can just run right through here. Now, I remember he said that if I come back through here again, he's got something to say. Use that device you have to take aims at the phantoms from behind. Yeah, it's similar to what we heard from the Cuba sisters that we heard about this trick later on. You know, the bow and arrow to shoot at their backs to stun them for a good while. Yeah, that's what he has to say. All right, now I'm going to go, I guess, around through here and hope I don't get seen. Okay. And the phantom eyes are in good timing, so I could just go right here, and there we go. I wish I wouldn't have gotten seen by that phantom eye back there, but that's okay. Alright, so. I believe there's a 30-second jigger that we can get over here. You can also recover your health and stuff like that if you've got, well, health lost. Like, yeah, stuff like that. But I'm not gonna... burn more time than is necessary by getting those, and oh yeah, that turns off the spikes too. I forgot shooting that eye does that. Oh yeah, and I also noticed that, well, not noticed, someone told me that I wrote the plus 30 over here at the edges of these rooms here, and well, they're supposed to be plus 15, so I might as well do the corrections as long as I'm here. Thank you for telling me. Okay, so map really quick. Because I want to pause the timer here. There we go. Oops. Oh, yeah, erase first. Because then I can do them all at once. Oh, shoot. I didn't want to erase the plus. Well. 1, 5, plus 1, 5. What the heck happened there? It's fine. It still looks like 15. And a plus 30, was it? I think it was. Well, it's a plus earth. So that's all that matters. We just got to get the plusers. Oh, wait. And one more thing. An eye right here. There we go. I don't know why I've been drawing them diagonally there, but whatever. Alright, now we got a Moldorm infestation this time. As I said, these floors are a little bit different than they were before. Oh, I am doing terrible on you, and you are a very easy enemy. Yeah, see, when they shrink their tail in, it just is always in the same relative position to their head, and then you just keep swinging at it from that position, and you're just able to knock it right out. That's why they're much easier than your typical Moldorm, even if they take... I was going to say, even if they take more hits, but come to think of it, I think the regular Moldorm might take more hits than that in a lot of situations. I can also speed this along, but oh, shoot, I was going to say by not getting out the boomerang. But I've managed to fail, but that is okay. What else is new? Big green rupee. And I don't think I can do anything about that left side shortcut for now, so I'm just gonna plop through here. And now, gotta work my way over to, yeah, we're here at the crested door. I should probably update that. I should say make a secondary mark on the map regarding that crest that we had. But first I gotta get this room, back into a position that I can actually reach the door.
And by doing that, I could do that. Oh, wait, actually, no, that's not right. It's, where is the other switch? I forgot where it is. Oh, wait, it's that. Yeah, that's right. Oh, whoopsie. Alright, so, for the map, what I'm going to do here is draw a secondary symbol right here, I guess. Because there's still the 30-second thingy that... that was terrible. So there's still a 30-second thingy that I can get in that room, I guess. But I'm not really too concerned about that. Like, in the other room, I should say, if I draw the symbol in the middle of the room. So, yeah, that's going to be what I'm going to do here. Alright, in a single stroke, draw the sacred crest to reveal a new path. Let's see here... Oop, that should do it. Wasn't the best, but it'll detect it. As long as you touch those hard corners together, it will detect it. And I made some pretty decent time there, so maybe I won't have to redo anything here on the first couple of floors. This room looks different than it did last time. Maybe we went to another place when we used the crest that Zauz showed us. Look at that, look at that. It's her turn. Oh, yes, the door card. See? Yeah, that crest, I mean, that door actually leads to two different rooms. That's kind of creepy if you think about it, or kind of weird if you think about it. I mean, door leading to different rooms if you draw different things on it. Yeah, Dark Terrors, look ahead. I'll share something with you that will help you survive. Behold, a checkpoint. Now, this checkpoint. Step into the yellow light to save your journey time and return to the entrance. Step into the yellow light at the temple entrance to return here instantly. In other words, this is a midpoint point, understand? No, it's too complicated. okay. Yeah. I'm just joking around. Okay, so if I go in here, it's going to say it took me this long to reach the room on our Phantom Hourglass. You know, it takes into account that I recovered my seconds with the 30s and the 15s along the way too. So it only cut off 2 minutes and 34 seconds off the Phantom Hourglass. That is not too shabby of a time. So if we do that, we'll return to the entrance, but we'll actually be able to come back here anytime that we want to now. You there, boy in green. I've seen a lot of you lately. The skeletons you see here are not prepared to enter this cursed place, but they now know many of the temple's secrets. If you want to know them, it'll cost you, but all you have to do is ask. Okay. I mean, well, we heard one secret from that one skeleton, you know, that he said to talk to him again, but whatever. Alright, so we can actually go back and forth now, thanks to this checkpoint. We can also improve our time as well by going back through the first 6 floors if you would like to. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that or not yet, though, but we'll see. But yeah, that's a pretty handy little shortcut, if I do say so myself, because now you don't have to do those first 6 floors ever again, even though they have been, you know, they have been playing differently each time you've come through here, but now that they really don't play any differently, we can pretty much leave them behind us. Did I get all that? Yeah, I did get all that. Well, anyway, I think I'm going to end off the part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part when I do a couple more floors. Oh, yes. How exciting. Oh, yes.